Alan Simon.
So hi everybody, so my name is Simon, Simone actually in Italian. So what we do, so we work for Apcera, and you guys heard a lot about containers and container orchestration systems and scheduling algorithm, and what we do, we provide a single platform that's all of that. It's a turnkey solution. You don't have to take pieces of open source software, put it together, it's all done. And as you can see from the slide, our job manager is actually responsible for the scheduling and orchestration. But we provide everything else. We provide packet management, we provide net management, we provide the metrics manager, and we can run not just in single data center, but we can span across multiple data centers and also multiple clouds. We support Amazon, VMware, OpenStack, Google, and once you deploy our solution into those platforms, it really becomes like a multi-cloud, a unified cloud. And where we are really, really good is in policy and governance. So when you create this huge cloud, you can even span across multiple states, go to the United States, to Europe, to Asia, you have the same level of policy and governance. And you can only control what a single user or a single developer can do, but you can also control everything that is done on the platform. So as a system administrator or operator, you can really set guidelines, and you can say, this set of developers can do just these things, they can use just these services. And we work with everything. We're gonna have a demo later. You can start from simple source code. You have source code in your laptop and you wanna run it. We just take it, package it, and run it on the platform. You have already a Docker container where your application is running. You can take it from there and run it on the platform, scale it, and everything. But you know, since we are at the NGINX conference, I want to talk a little bit about what we do with NGINX. And for that, I'll give it to Beth.
Sure. Hi. So I've been a C programmer for about 20 years. So first of all, I want to say, I absolutely love NGINX, and I want to thank the NGINX team for building this wonderful product and making it simple. That aside, so what we use NGINX for, most of our system is written in Go, but what we use NGINX for is for managing the HTTP traffic and routing it to the right components. We also use it for the SSL termination. As it happens, our platform uses NATS, which is a publish subscribe messaging system for the control plane. And so we dynamically reconfigure NGINX, NGINX's upstream module, with the hundreds or thousands of job instances running on the cluster. And for that, we developed our own module, which is a plugin into NGINX. We also recently open sourced the NATS PubSub client, so if anybody else is interested in using the NATS technology inside NGINX, there is now a client module that does that. And I just want to say again, we absolutely love NGINX.
All right, demo time. So just a little bit of a slide of the demo. So this is my setup. I have a data center and different type of the world. Some is local in our office, some is running on Amazon, some is running on Google, and we have this really huge unified cloud. So me as a developer, I have just code running my laptop. I don't need to install on my laptop anything like Docker or any fancy thing. This is just my Mac, and I have code in the directory, and here it is. The only thing I need to do, I need to log into my cluster. And as you can see, now I'm logging into the demo cluster called demo.apcera.net. I'm logging as a demo user, and I'm gonna be playing in my sandbox. This is like a cluster that you can divide in different logical spaces, so every developer can have their own sandbox, and you can have a namespace for production, a namespace for testing, a namespace for staging. So the code is here under my server, and server.js is. So the only thing I need to do is to do apc server command app create and give it a name of the app. In this case, I'm gonna call it demo. Automatically, the system is gonna start the staging process, and it's gonna just look at the code, and by looking at the code, you notice that the code was written in Node.js, so it's using the stager, it's Node.js, and we have stager for everything, Node, Java, Ruby, Bash, simple HTML. In fact, this application is a mix between Node.js and HTML, and the stager is actually doing both work, Node.js and stager. But while this one is dying, it's doing and it's preparing the container, and it quickly switch to our UI, and that's what the system administrator is going to be working on, where I can see the status of the old cluster. This is a pretty small cluster, it's 60 gig with pretty much a terabyte of space. It's my demo. And if I look at the instance manager, these are all the virtual machines that are running all around the world, and I can just tag them. For example, this instance manager is running on Google, this one is running on Amazon, this is running on-prem in VMware, this actually is in Asia. And as a system administrator, I can also set up policy. If I look, for example, at demo policy, the developer has no idea this is happening, but I can set up, right now he's a developer, he has only this permission on the cluster, he can do only this kind of permission, only this kind of action on databases. I can set up quotas, so today I want to give him 256 megabytes per container, I can do it, tomorrow I want to give him 512, I can just change, so as an administrator, a single pane of glass to change everything. So I see my application has finished staging in the meantime, and actually it's finished already, and I can just start it. And the beauty is, like, clearly I have an Heroku type of interface where I can just start application, stop application, scale application. And automatically, right now, I mean, Lab knows more than I do, but we are assigning a URL to the container. So if I click on that URL, here I go, I have my sample app. That actually shows me where the server, where the container got deployed. In this case, it got deployed in the United Kingdom. So let's say now I grow as a company and I need my application to run everywhere in the world because I have customers in the United States, customers in Asia and everywhere. I can simply come here, go under jobs, select my sandbox, demo, that's what I was running, select my app, and scale it to 10 instances, for example. That's so easy to scale an app. I can, for example, look at the logs of the app, and here all the apps are coming alive, one after another. If I go back on details, refresh. Here I go, I have all my apps running. And now my demo app, the only thing it's doing is actually, every time I send a request and I do a refresh, we configure NGINX to randomly send me to a different app that I've been deployed. And now it sent me to the instance that's running in the United States. Refresh again, now I'm back in the United Kingdom. And this is really random, it's not the demo. In reality, what you want to do is if you have customer in Europe, you send them to the instance in Europe. If you have customer in the United States, you send them to the instance in the United States. And we support all this. And the Apcera, if you want more information, here's my site, and thanks a lot.